Up to recent times, all humans lived in an environment that is similar to Kwaku's environment. Up to recent times, we were all farmers, who had a lot of physical exercise and diets with low caloric foods. Our bodies, our genes, have evolved to survive in these environments of scarcity for tens of thousands of years. That we have special receptors on our tongue to detect sugar can be understood from this. These receptors are connected to the pleasure center in our brain, and each time we eat sugar, we think it tastes good and it gives us pleasure. Evolutionary, there is a good explanation for this, since sugar is high in calories and therefore important for survival in our old environment. Similarly, the signal that we have eaten enough comes 20 minutes after your meal, when you're sitting on the couch thinking you might have slightly overeaten, is also a result of the adaptation to an environment with scarcity. We are designed or programmed to eat a little bit more than we need for just now and store the excess energy in fat reserves for worse times to come. You never knew when you would find food again. But our environment has changed dramatically in the past few hundred years. We no longer live in an environment of scarcity. There is an abundant availability of food in our modern environment. Supermarkets are always full and have bananas and cola every day of the year, sometimes even 24 hours a day. We are no longer subject to food shortages, dry seasons, floods, or misharvests. Let me prove this by a little experiment. Look at this cake. Imagine that you take a bite from the sweet strawberries with the freshly whipped cream. Imagine the delicious taste in your mouth. Do you notice what is happening? The water in your mouth? That's from your old genes telling you that this is good for you. Calories to survive. Take two pieces. Now, our evolutionary heritage does not only explain why we overconsume. Our evolutionary heritage also explains why we prefer to use the escalator to the stairs and the car to walking. I have a slide to illustrate this. Why do people do this? Don't they know that it is healthy to take the stairs every now and then? That we already have very little exercise during a day? Of course, we all know that. But we prefer the escalator because of our evolutionary heritage. In our old environment, we had to be frugal with the calories that we had worked so hard for hunting or farming. But our modern environment, we hardly have any exercise. Cars and trains to transport ourselves and all our stuff. We have machines in every house to do the dishes, wash our clothes. I have a friend that even has an electric pepper mill. If you want pepper on your meal, you press a button, and an electric motor grinds the pepper for you. Here's a slide that illustrates the problem in one image. Why do we first abandon exercise from our daily environment and then build rooms with machines that you can walk on without progressing 1 meter to get our daily exercise at the end of the day? Some claim that people are lazy by nature, but I would never make that claim. People are efficient. There's also an evolutionary explanation for that, because we had to be in our environment of scarcity. The ones that were not efficient did not make it. Let me give you another example. Look at this man. You can dress him in a nice suit, give him a fancy suitcase. But deep down inside, every man, although this is not as easily recognized in every man remains a hunter from the savannah that has to be efficient to survive until his next kill. Think about that the next time you see a heavily overweight person on an electric bike or on the escalator. It's a hunter from the savannah in the wrong environment. Now, people are like this everywhere. There are people who collect desire lanes using Google Maps. They find them from London to Tokyo, from Copenhagen to Cape Town. We have lived for tens of thousands of years in an environment of scarcity. Our genes, our bodies have adapted, but our environment has suddenly changed, and our genes have not adapted yet. They are in mismatch with our current environment, and this mismatch is the basis of our unhealthy aging patterns. The mismatch is clear when it comes to diet and to physical activity, but there are other areas in which our environment has changed fundamentally. In the way we sleep, for example, in the way we interact with each other, and in the way we deal with stress. All important factors for healthy aging. Watch the next video to see how.